So let's start with the ninth nakshatra, Ashlesha. What we are going to do? Mantra of the nakshatra, stories of the nakshatra, result of the padas and remedies. In the previous video, I forgot to tell you the remedy for Pushya. So by the end of this video, while I will cover the remedy for Ashlesha, I will also cover the remedy for Pushya. Coming to Ashlesha, remember, just understand one very particular thing about Ashlesha. Ashlesha is ruled by snake. Right? Ashlesha is ruled by a snake. Regarding snake, you know what? One of my teachers told me that all of us living in India are the ancestors of snakes. The whole land is ruled by snakes. Complete of India is ruled by snakes. And the worship of snakes is from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Assam to Gujarat. Snakes are our ancestors. And for this particular reason, Ashlesha indicates the work left by your ancestors. Everyone born in this earth is with three Ranas, debt. Devarin, Rishirin, Pitrarin. And the Pitrarin, the debt of your ancestors is to produce children. Right? The debt of your ancestors is to produce children to continue the lineage. And for this particular matter, Ashlesha is very much related to the birth of children. And the karma of Ashlesha is a very important and crucial step in the karma of Ashlesha is to produce a progeny. Point one. Right? Firstly, the relationship of Ashlesha people with their children is either very sore or very good. Right? There is no way about it. Right? The production of progeny is something very important and very crucial for Ashlesha. Along with this, snakes are also considered the guardian of treasures. And Ashlesha is a very wealthy nakshatra. Someone told me that the Shettis of South India are very rich because they worship snakes. Right? So snake and specifically the Ashlesha is very much related to money. It gives you money, prosperity and wealth. Provided the fact that Ashlesha is benefic. If Ashlesha is malefic, then there will be problem related to progeny and problem related to wealth. How a nakshatra becomes malefic or benefic? If the malefic planets are posited in the nakshatra, it is malefic, afflicted. When the benefic planet are posited in the nakshatra is good. There are other conditions also. The nakshatra in which Mars starts getting retrograde is considered afflicted. The nakshatra where the last lunar or solar eclipse have happened is considered bad, right? So there are many considerations for a nakshatra being bad. And that I have discussed in the course in depth. I have discussed this in depth in the course. If the response to the video is good, that is absolutely being there. Then by the end of the series, I will continue with how the nakshatras are afflicted and how the nakshatras are not afflicted. Okay. The third thing, the snakes are very much related to enjoying the life. That is the theme of Ashlesha, the enjoyment of life. See, nakshatra like rashis and like houses indicate a particular thing. When they are afflicted, that thing is challenged. When they are good, that thing is available for good. As an example, Aries indicates courage, right? Courage and movement, undertaking of new responsibilities indicated by Aries, right? Because that is a sign ruled by Mars and that is a movable sign, right? So your tendency to find new work to be that needs to be done and doing that particular thing is indicated by Aries, right? Movable sign ruled by Mars. Mars indicates what? Work karma. So Aries indicates your tendency to find new work and doing it successfully. That is indicated by Aries. And when Aries is afflicted, this thing is a problem, right? So all the 12 signs, all the 12 houses indicate a particular theme. For an example, take the 7th house. That indicates marriage. And marriage is one of the important theme of marriage. Marriage is an important theme of life. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha, right? And marriage is important for kama. And when there is a malefic planet in the 7th house, that particular portion of life is disturbed, right? In the same way, all the 27 nakshatras indicate the complete life, like all the states of life, the different states of life. And in those different states, Ashlesha specifically indicates the enjoyment in life, right? Enjoying the life, enjoying the things in life, enjoying money in life, enjoying wealth in life, enjoying treasures in life. And when it is afflicted by a planet, that enjoyment is not there. This is the basic way to see nakshatras, right? Once again, as I told you, Ashlesha class, sharing secrets, right? That thing is particularly there, right? When the Kaliya Mardan scene comes, right? When Krishna goes to slay Kaliya Nag, Kaliya is sitting deep down in the Yamuna with his many wives. And he has a lot of jewels, etc. with him, right? So having multiple wives does indicate sexual enjoyment, right? When Ashlesha is good, you are faithful to a wife and you enjoy life with her, right? When Ashlesha is bad, then you go on having relationship with multiple women. And why one jumps from one relationship to another? Because he is not able to find himself in one particular relationship. He is not able to find solace in a particular relationship, right? That becomes the problem. So that will be the problem with Ashlesha as well, right? That is enjoyment, both material, spiritual, physical, all type of enjoyments, right? And when this nakshatra is good, that thing is available in your life in a good sense. And when that nakshatra is afflicted, that particular thing is available in your life in a bad sense. Getting my point? Understand one more thing. Like a horoscope. Okay? Like a horoscope. Right? So as I just told you, all the Rashis, all the nakshatras, all the houses indicates different aspects of life, right? When you have a planet in a particular nakshatra, that signification is prominent. When you have a planet in a nakshatra, in a Rashi or in a house, that particular thing is prominent in your life, right? Now, it is prominent in a good sense. It is prominent in a bad sense. The presence is prominent or the absence is prominent. That is dependent on the planet and other things. Do you get my point? You have to understand it. And this needs to be understood in a very wide perspective. Right? Let's take an example. If you have a planet in the 7th house, marriage is very prominent for you. Good planet. The wife, the marital life is very good and the wife supports you in everything. A bad 7th life, the marital life is bad and that creates very strong dilemma in your life, very strong obstructions in your life, right? For those people who don't have a planet in the 7th house, marriage is not a very important karma, right? Getting my point? Whether they get married or they remain unmarried, it doesn't change much for them. Getting my point? It will not change much for them. Someone having a 7th planet in the 7th house, either they become prosperous after marriage or they become they lose prosperity after marriage. One thing of them is prominent. But if you don't have a client in 7th house, right? Like Janmeja ji, you are not having any client in 7th house, right? So your life before marriage and your life after marriage almost same. You are a self-made man and your wife have no control over whatever you've achieved or lost. Right? That's all depend on you. The same thing is with nakshatras also, right? So when there is a planet in Ashlesha, Ashlesha is enjoyment. A snake is all type of enjoyment, right? Enjoying with wife or enjoying money or enjoying power. Okay. When a planet is there, that enjoyment is in your life. When a good planet is there, that enjoyment gives you multiple things. When a bad planet is there, that enjoyment takes away multiple things from you. Getting my point? For an example, you know, there is a book that I think every successful person should read. That is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. And he have told one of many motivations for success is the motivation of sexuality as well. Many people have become successful only to prove their spouse or their lovers that they can really be successful. Right? The spouse is from a higher start of society and they don't marry them because they are not rich enough, and then they take it as a challenge. Right? And to prove that they can also be on that level, they go on the path to success. Getting my point? So when there is a good planet in Ashlesha, you enjoy in life, and that enjoyment, that contentment, that happiness makes you achieve more. Whereas when there is a malefic planet in Ashlesha, you don't enjoy in life, and that emptiness, that being alone, that not being able to enjoy life gives a great void to your life. And you are not able to enjoy, you are not able to feel contented, you are not able to feel satisfied because of that. Getting my point? That is very important. Right? Going further, Ashlesha indicating snake and snakes guard treasures, right? So Ashlesha person is having a treasure. That can be any kind of treasure, intellectual treasure, monetary treasure, any kind of treasure, right? That treasure is there and guarding that treasure is there. And guarding that treasure is there, right? So when there is a good planet in Ashlesha, you have a treasure and you will be able to guard it. When a bad planet is in Ashlesha, then you have a treasure and that will fall prey to other people. Like things like theft will happen. Malefic planet in Ashlesha, you know, there are astrology teachers who will tell you that, you know, this came to me, he stole my technique and started teaching it to other people. They have a bad Ashlesha or a bad Sadvesha. Because other people are coming and able to steal things from you, right? You come try stealing something from my course. Let's see how you can do. You will not be able to. Because that is highly guarded. Even if you get all the recordings out, you will not be able to. Do you get my point? That particular thing, are you able to? Getting my point? Suppose I am guarding the values of my family, the values of my ancestors, right? Okay. If I have a good Ashlesha, I will be able to value the ethics of my ancestors, right? If I have a bad Ashlesha, then I will be the first one who will digress from the ethics of the family. I will be the first one who will break the rule, and after me, many people will do. In the family, at least there is one person who goes to a bad business. And after that, everyone goes in the family. Isn't it? Right? In every family, everyone is in business. There is one person who will break the chain and will go to job. Or everyone is in job and there will be one person who will break the chain and will go to business, and after that everyone will follow. So that breaker of the chain or that upholder of the chain is indicated by Ashlesha. Depending on it is good or bad, right? Because the symbol of Ashlesha indicates a circle. You think about it, indicates a circle. When you have a strong Ashlesha, you strengthen the circle. That means you follow the ethics of your family and your children also follow the ethics of your family. You give such sanskar to your children, such training to your children, that they also follow the ethics. Strong Ashlesha. Weak Aslesha, you break the ethics and your children also become rogue. Your children also become a problem. They also become a rule breaker. Bringing digress to family, right? So that indicates multiple type of treasure, be it monetary or anything. Got my point? That is the basic theme for Aslesha. Okay? The Shloka. Right? I think this much is enough. But still, as we have the tendency of going deeper and deeper and deeper. You know, I can teach you one nakshatra for 2-3 days altogether, right? There's so much of content. But at least at one point of time, we have to put some break. But in the course, we are taking like nakshatras from 4 different perspectives. So you can like better imagine. If I'm doing 2-hour class per nakshatra and doing it 4 times, then 6 hours at least, right? 4 to just 6. And that is, we are doing just level 1. So the knowledge is very extensive about nakshatras, right? So don't be like, you know, that there is nothing much. You have to think on the things that I am saying, right? Because I may not be able to convey it in a good way. And it's not like that I cannot convey it in a good way. I actually don't want to. Because you know what? As a teacher, I always have a responsibility that the knowledge should go to the person, but not to the unworthy one. That's why I don't teach it in a very lucrative way, very open way. Getting my point? Because I have something very real. And I cannot let it free in everyone's hands. So think on everything that I'm saying. That's why I don't simplify it. Because simplification means it can be misused and aslesha, right? I have to make sure that it is not misused. Right. Sarpana masreshayaha. Aslesha is the embrace of the snake. What does that mean? Aslesha comes with uneasiness. When aslesha starts affecting you, it starts with an uneasiness. This is the breaking of the shell. We always say, na, a cocoon will turn into a butterfly. But that process is very problematic. That process is indicated by aslesha. Aslesha indicates you being pushed in a well before you really fly. The conditions will become very hard for you. For an example, if the seventh lord is in Aslesha and if he is going to have a very good marriage, then he will have multiple difficulties in finding the right partner. He will have multiple difficulties in getting into a relationship. Generally, they will see 4, 5, 6 years of being alone. Why? Because they are going to have a very good spouse, right? So that testing, that pressure, that transformative time is to come, right? That is an essential and integral part of it. The embrace of snake, you know, snakes don't have teeth. They gulp down animals and they break their bones by the pressure, right? So the bone breaking pressure is there. If your 10th lord is in Aslesha, then just before the success in your professional life, there will be a long break. Break of 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, at least 6 months will be there, right? And that break will be very painful. You're struggling for money. Right? You're struggling to keep yourself up for a long time. 1 year, 2 year will be there. After that, you will succeed. Is getting my point? See, this is a chart. And in this chart, the Lagna is Aslesha Pada 2. This person wanted a child because he was the only child of his parents, right? So for the continuation of lineage, this person wanted a child. And if you look at the horoscope very carefully, there are very less chances of having a child. Right, the fifth lord, Mars is not in a very good condition to give child. He's not powerful, he's not strong. And the fifth house is indicated by Saturn. Sorry, aspected by Saturn, right? The third aspect of Saturn, 1, 2, 3. So the progeny is really, really difficult. But this person had a progeny. Before he died, this person had a progeny. But you know when he got the progeny? he remained unemployed for 7 years. And after the 7 years of unemployment, he got a job. And at the same time, simultaneously, his wife also conceived. And then he got a child, right? Aslesha and the ascendant. So there's a bone-crushing pressure. There is difficult situation like death before you really achieve something. It is with the ascendant, so that is the trend of life. Getting my point? Do you understand it or not? So see, Rahu is also in Aslesha. I always told this person to, like, you know, the day he met, I always told him, you do astrology. This person always denied, oh, no, no, I will not do. I want to do astrology when I am very old, after 80 years of age. And I always kept on doing him, you do. And as I told you, he remained unemployed for 7 years, right? By the end of that 7th year, he decided that, no, whatever you are saying, Subham, is right. I'm like, I am an astrologer. I am always right. Right. There are only two right people in the world, woman and astrologers. Right? Women are always right, astrologers are always right. Two people. And no third one. Right. In the end, to break the 7 years of unemployment, he had to do an astrological job. Rahu, right? So that denial that, no, I am not going to do it, will come. Then the pressure of the snake will come. That you have to do it. That's the only way to earn money. Right? He was into journalism and no media house was accepting him. So in the end, after 7 years, this person was all broken. He also tried business, but it was not being successful. His partners were cheating him. So after 7 years, he finally gave up that, no, I'm going to do astrology. And then it worked. Getting my point? The pressure. Aslesha also indicates a circle. So the things keep on repeating. So you don't think that the suffering is gone once. No. Aslesha is a circle, and you know, there is, I told something about Osho, that Osho had enlightenment every 7 years. After every 7 years, he started having enlightenment. So in 7 years, he will get enlightened, then he will forget his enlightenment. Then he will get enlightenment again. Then he will forget the enlightenment. Then he will get enlightenment again. That is indicated by Aslesha. You get something, you realize something, then you forget it. Then once again, you realize it, then you forget it, right? You know, there is a repetitive mistake that we always do. Like, you decide not to eat rasgulla from tomorrow, not to eat sweets from tomorrow. You will remember it today. Tomorrow you will start eating. Then one day doctor will tell you have high cholesterol. So you will leave it. But after living for 1 month, you will once again start eating it. Getting my point? So that chain is indicated of Aslesha. And when you have a planet in Aslesha, that chain is prominent in your life. When you don't have a planet in Aslesha, that change is not prominent in your life. Do you understand my point? Yes. This is what it does indicate. The shloka is Sarpa Nama Shreshaha Abhyagachita. Abhyagachita means someone or something who is not approaching directly. So there are two ways to hold the ear. This is what we say in Hindi. Kaan pakadne ke do tarike. One this and one this, right? So not doing the thing in the direct way. Aslesha always finds an indirect way. You cannot approach Aslesha directly. You have to go through an indirect way. So how do you propose other? You get in love with the lady and you tell her that I like you. That is normal way. Aslesha, no. Aslesha, get in a fight, then go into a love, right? That is not a direct way. That is a very indirect way to do it. Getting my point? So this is what happens with Aslesha. How do you join a job? You apply for the job and you do it, right? Aslesha, no. You challenge that I can do this work. And just to show that you can do this particular work, you accept the challenge. And then you do the work so good that the company employs you, right? So Aslesha is not going to approach something very directly. Like 10,000 indicates fame. And for everyone, fame comes gradually. But for Aslesha, fame is not going to come gradually. It will come in another way. The fame will come through defamation. The fame will come through bad fame. And that's not a very good way. Generally, people become famous, then they become defamous. then they have defame. For Asalacia, the way is absolutely opposite. First they get defamed, then they get fame. There are many people who are just known for bad things. Right? Generally, a singer sings good for many years and after that his voice will start deteriorating and people will say that now he's not able to sing well. Why he's getting job? Why he's getting singing contracts, right? Asalacia is another way. He sings bad. But people will start appreciating it after some time. I don't want to take the name of those people who are a good example on this, but still you understand, right? You understand. That is what happens, right? The next thing in this show is there's two more things into this particular thing. Asalacia doesn't indicate reaching. Asalacia doesn't signify going. Asalacia signifies reaching. So, you know, there is something very peculiar with Asalacia. Asalacia, when they try to do something, when they try to achieve something, they are not going to have it easily. You know, there is a story. I was reading a book by Ryuyo Okawa, Invincible Thinking, way back in 2013-14. I was working in a publishing company. I think most of you people know. I worked in one of the leading publishing companies of India for many years. And I was reading one particular book that was published by the publication itself. And there was a very good statement that, you know, a dog runs behind his tail. And since the time he keep on running behind his tail, he keep on roaming at the same place, right? Round and round and round because he wants to bite his tail. But the time the dog stops running behind his tail and start going forward, he proceeds in life. He succeeds in life, right? He gave it an example for love or any other thing. The time when you try to reach for success, it is a circle. The time when you don't care for success, you reach there, right? So Asalacia, see, snake, do snakes have legs? How many legs snakes will have? They have no legs, right? Asalacia, when they try to do something, when they try to achieve something, it is very difficult for them to reach at that particular place. When they try to achieve a particular stuff, that is very difficult for them to have. When they actually stop doing it, then they automatically achieve it. Asalacia is all and all a story of ignorance and achievement. So when you have fifth lord in Asalacia, you try for child, you don't have a child. The time when you stop trying for child, when you lose all your hopes and you are like, okay, if we are not going to have a child, not an issue, let me adopt a child. After that, you get a child. And there are many such stories, right? People adopt a child and after that they have. Just to say, I had one particular chart. I'm not able to find by which name I saved that particular chart. So there was a lady, okay, who was trying to conceive for a child. Like, she was cancer, isn't it? She wanted to conceive a child but was not able to do it even after 18 years of marriage. So what she did, she took the child of her younger sister, right? Generally, it happens in places. They take the child of their younger sister and treat them as their own child. Just after 2 years of this particular incident, the lady became pregnant and she gave birth to twins. Ascendant was in Asalacia, third pada, I think, if I remember well. The third pada of Asalacia was there, right? That is a particular thing with Asalacia. When you try to reach, it is difficult. But when you don't care about it, things come as a surprise. You stumble across that particular. The same result will be there if the fifth lord is in Asalacia. The same result will be there when Jupiter is in Asalacia, right? Don't run behind things. Be carefree and you will achieve. Right? And, you know, one more tendency of Asalacia is Asalacia don't reach to something directly, as I just told you. It is told that Asalacia reaches dancing. When Asalacia wants to reach at some place, they don't go directly. Snake will not go directly. Snake will go this way, right? Zigzag, zigzag, zigzag. So it is taken as that they go dancing, right? So that is one particular thing. For Aslesha, you should never lose. Just a second. I'm going to tell you a few, like, you know, the philosophical story about this particular machine. And, you know, this is see, life is filled. I always say one thing. Life is filled up of lessons, right? And every lesson is not for everyone. One particular way for me. In Sakti Sadhana, there is a call. Okay. There is a Vam Marga, there is Dakshina Marga, right hand path, left hand path, call, this, that. Every path is not for everyone, right? In the worship, there is the approach of a lover, the approach of a brother, the approach of a child, the approach of a husband, the approach of a father, right? And not every approach is for everyone, right? So for Aslesha, I'm also telling you the particular story or the philosophical thought behind it. The snake will reach something dancing, right? What does that mean? For Aslesha, any plant in Aslesha, when you do that thing with complete focus, you are very, you are not supposed to achieve it. When you do it just for fun, when you do it just for enjoyment, then you are supposed to achieve it. For an example, if you have seventh lord in Aslesha, you make a profile on bharatmatrimony.com. Okay. And you start searching for the bride, you are not going to find it. Right? The time when you stop searching for the bride, but invested, start looking for people to have friendship with, at that particular point of time, you are supposed to meet your spouse, right? So enjoying the process is what will lead Aslesha to their goal. Because once again, what I told in the previous Pushya video, a planet in a nakshatra indicates the temperament, nature, quality, or the mood of the planet, right? You cannot change the mood of the planet, mind it. You cannot change the mood of the planet. You can just mold yourself to the mood of the planet. The planetary forces are very strong for you to be against them. The planetary forces are like air. And there is a saying, right? If you want to reach to the destination, sail with the wind. So going against the planet is going against the wind. I always say one particular thing. If you have the combination to become an engineer, you can become a lawyer as well. You can become a doctor as well. But you will not be successful there. When you become a lawyer, you will be successful in that particular field, right? That's why you use astrology. So Aslesha can give you non-achievement. Aslesha can give you disappointment. And Aslesha can also give you achievement. When it will give you achievement? When you will go to the way of Aslesha. When you will go through the way of Aslesha. If you don't follow the way of Aslesha, then what Aslesha will give you? Disappointment, right? Yes, Rico is very right here. Rico understood it very well. If the ascendant is in Aslesha and no planet is in Aslesha, then native should be enjoying everything in life. So rather than focusing on the goal that I have to do this particular thing, they should enjoy it. Getting my point? For an example, I have moon in Aslesha. Have you seen my courses, etc.? I don't teach what people want. I do what I do, right? The enjoyment, the self-content. Getting my point? That is with Aslesha. You do what you enjoy doing. When I want to teach Murta, I teach Murta. When I want to teach Prashna, I teach Prashna, right? Out of no competition. Getting my point? This is the way of Aslesha. So planetary energies are very high. You should not have the approach of that I will, you know, win over it. No. You should embrace it. Embrace the ways of the planet. Embrace the way of the nakshatra, that is the way to success. Achieve something through enjoyment. Okay? No focus, enjoyment. Aslesha, see, when a snake goes through a path, animals leave their path, okay? There is no animal who will fight with the snake. They're supposed to leave their path, right? That is what you are, understand it. Okay? And Aslesha is always progressing. Any planet in Aslesha, it will never stop progressing. Acalasia is always progressive. Acalasia is known as something that is always moving. So whichever planet is in Acalasia, there is always a development related to that planet. You know what? I have moon in Acalasia and I 24/7, I read about the development of mind, the development of personality. This is my favorite topic to read. Mind. I read about mind, the workings of mind, the function of mind, right? That is my favorite thing to do. Any planet in Acalasia is constantly improving. Venus in Acalasia, person loves to read about lovemaking, etc., etc., right? That is the only thing they put their whole concentration on. Jupiter in Acalasia, someone very highly focused on reading about the Vedas, Puranas, and Shastras, right? And the philosophy, etc. Right? And Acalasia also indicates someone getting moksha. That is the Gandhanth Tara, that is the Gandhanth Nakshatra, right? Acalasia also indicates someone getting moksha. So when Acalasia is powerful, when Acalasia is benefic, that also indicates salvation. Well, once again, the way of salvation is not achievement. This way of salvation is enjoying, right? As you go into spirituality, you become more and more free. That is the way of Acalasia. Right, and Acalasia's prime focus is to become king. The snakes want to become king. So whichever planet is in Acalasia, understand one particular thing. Any planet is in Acalasia, you are not supposed to achieve something related to that planet in the starting part of life. Whichever planet is in Acalasia, you have a abhav. You have a lack of that particular thing in your life. And you have to achieve that gradually in life. So if the sun is in Acalasia, your father is not very supportive. Almost absent. And you have to become your own father and later on should become a father for many in the world, right? Have to support many children in the world, right? So Acalasia indicates approaching the king. That means you don't have that particular thing, whichever planet is in Acalasia. But you have to get the higher octave of that particular planet, okay? Acalasia indicates a spy. Acalasia indicates someone who is secretly between all the members of the society. And he spies things between. Right? So Acalasia is, I have moon in Acalasia, right? Acalasia is someone who knows everyone's secret. Acalasia is someone who's like a spy. Like Acalasia is very much engrossed under the skin. That is also indicated by Acalasia. Right? Very final, very like interwoven in a very fine way is indicated by Acalasia. Whichever planet is in Acalasia, you understand every little thing about that particular stuff, right? When when moon is in Acalasia, you understand mind very well. When Jupiter is in Acalasia, you understand dharma very well. When Mercury is in Acalasia, you understand education very well. When sun is in Acalasia, you understand how to rule very well, right? When the Mars is in Acalasia, you understand, the karma very well. When Saturn is in Acalasia, you understand the disease, the depth, the suffering very well, right? So Acalasia gives you a very fine and very intricate knowledge of why something is happening. Acalasia also indicates someone who is very well informed. Acalasia indicates the tendency of keeping up with the technology. Right. So when sun is in Acalasia, this person is someone who is very well known of whatever is happening in the political sphere. You know, there was an politician. He was known as a politician who will eat politicians. He was known as a politician. It was told that this politician eats politician. He never became like a president or prime minister or chief minister of any state. But he was someone who was known for breaking politicians because he knew everyone's secrets. And he was favored of both the wings. Congress and BJP both loved him because he knew secrets of all. So that is what Acalasia is. People don't want to mess up with Acalasia because they know your secret. So messing up is really a bad problem. Acalasia, right? So intricately woven, and very well informed. Whichever planet is in Ashlesha, you are very, very well informed about the that particular topic. Sun in Ashlesha, very well informed about politics. Moon in Ashlesha, very well informed about new changes in the world, the trends in the world. Moon in Ashlesha generally makes someone very good in intuition, very good in, you know, sensing things beforehand, because that makes you very well versed in understanding the workings of the mind. And Ashlesha indicates a very bad person. And Ashlesha indicates someone who is a bad person. Ashlesha indicates someone who don't have a very good approach. Right? That indicates someone who is engaged in a bad karma. So, like, you are born in Ashlesha. And it indicates someone who is born, who is supposed to do bad karma. What you should do then? Why it is told? You have malefics in 10th house, right? That means you will do bad karma, you will commit bad karma. Then what you should do? Why you come to astrology? To understand yourself, right? That's why it is essential for everyone to learn astrology. So I am born in Ashlesha. And I know that Ashlesha indicates someone who is a dusht, who is a bad man. Not bad man, okay? Who is a bad man, right? Someone who is engaging in bad karma. What should I do? I should understand it, relish it, and should avoid doing bad karma. Do you get my point? That thing is important. That thing is very important. Getting my point? Now, quickly jumping to the different padas of Ashlesha, okay? Here, I want to tell you something. Ashlesha is a Gandhant Tara. Gand means not, Ant means the end of it. So there are Rashis and there are Nakshatras and they are like two wheels. They are like two wheels, right? Wheel one, wheel two. Suppose this is Nakshatra and this is Rashi. Outer one is Nakshatra and the inner one is Rashi, right? What is Gandhant? I will make you understand, okay? This is Ashwini. Sorry, this is Aries. And in that Aries, from this point to this point, it is Ashwini. To understand this point is very crucial. This is Ashwini. This is the span of Bharani. And this is the span of Kritika. So what happens here, the Rashi will end, but the Nakshatra will continue. So although there is a break, there is no break in this circle, right? Suppose there is a puncture and you put a rubber patch here, right? That is what happens with every Rashi. From Aries, it will continue to Taurus. From Taurus, it will continue to Gemini. But you know what will happen with Cancer? Right here at this place, Cancer will end. And right here at this place, Ashlesha will also end. So there is a gap in the Rashi, wheel, and there is a gap in the Nakshatra wheel at this particular point. And that is the end of Ashlesha and the start of Magha. That is known as Gandhant, the ending of the knot. The Nakshatra circle and the Rashi circle both are broken at the same place. And that is considered a weak point in the zodiac. So there are 3 Gandhantas, including 6 stars. Because one which is ending and one which is starting, right? So two. First Gandhanta is Revati ending, Ashwini starting, okay? Second is Ashlesha ending, Magha starting. Third is Jyeshtha ending, Mula starting. So these 3 are Gandhantas. Gandhanta are of many types. One is the Rashi Gandhanta when the moon is in such a place. One is the Lagna Gandhanta when the ascendant is in such a place. And one is Tithi Gandhanta. Tithi Gandhanta is a different topic. I am not dealing about it, right? It will make it complex. Got it? If a child is born in Gandhanta, he will die. Okay? Generally said. But if you read the result of Gandhanta, not every child will die. So generally, for people born in Gandhanta, there are different results. For an example, someone, Ashlesha is a Gandhanta, right? Someone born in the fourth pada of Ashlesha is very bad for their father. So if a child is born in the fourth pada of Ashlesha, then it is bad for the father. That means the downfall of the father will start after the birth of the child. Or the child will not have a very good and very cordial relationship with their father, right? So there are different results for different padas of different nakshatras which make the Gandhanta. One of the prime results is the death of the child itself. And other results are death of the mother, death of the father, loss of money, death of the sibling, death of the, you know, death of the mother and father of the spouse, etc., etc. Okay, different results are given. But the opinion of Garga is very important. If someone is born in Gandhanta, either the Rashi Gandhanta or the ascendant Gandhanta. Rashi Gandhanta is Munir Gandhanta, the ascendant Gandhanta is ascendant degree in Gandhanta, right? If someone is born in Gandhanta and if he doesn't die, if he lives, then he will be a king. Is told by Garga. Getting my point? Now, whether the person will die or not, you have to find using other longevity formulas, right? And longevity is one of the most complex topics in astrology, as you may be knowing by now. Getting my point? That is for the Gandhanta of ascendant or moon. Regarding other planets, you know, I also use Gandhanta for every planet. I don't use Gandhanta for only these two. If any other planet is in Gandhanta, then what is Gandhanta? No support, right? Then that planet is not supported. Generally, a planet will be in a Rashi and a planet will be in a Nakshatra, right? But in the case of Gandhanta, despite the planet being in a Rashi and despite the planet being in a Nakshatra, he's not supported. His activities are not supported, which means the person is supposed to suffer related to the signification of that planet, right? So Venus in Gandhanta, you are not supported by your wife in anything. Problematic. Right? Sun in Gandhanta, you are not supported by your father. Moon in Gandhanta, I already explained you, right? Mars in Gandhanta, you are not supported by your sibling, you are not supported by your anger, you are not supported by your hard work, you are not supported by your work, right? Multiple things. Mars in Gandhanta, everything that Mars indicates, you are not supported in those things. That is problematic. Right? Generally, you will see people with exalted sun have very bad relationship with their fathers. Because sun becomes exalted in Ashwini, and as I told you, Ashwini is a Gandhanta Nakshatra, right? So that crucial point needs to be taken into consideration. One more thing. So what do you understand? Ashlesha is ending and Magha is starting, okay? And in the Nakshatra, there will be four quarters, four charan, right? So for Ashlesha, first one will be bad. Second will be very bad. Third will be even more bad. Fourth will be worst. It is coming to the end, right? For Magha, first will be very bad. Second will be less bad. Third will be even less bad. Fourth will be very less bad because that is going away. Getting my point? These two things should be taken into consideration, right? Someone told me that I haven't talked about Gandhanta when I was talking about Ashwini first pada. Because that I'm just explaining one particular thing, right? And that is just one part of the course. I think for students, I have described Gandhanta in the first part of the course. If I haven't, then don't worry. It is in the third part of the course, very extensive. How to decide one will die or not, etc. And different results. Because if you marry a lady born in Vishakha, then don't live with your family. If you are born in Vishakha or your wife is born in Vishakha or you have a planet in Vishakha or your wife is having a planet in Vishakha, then don't live with your family. You live with your family, your marital life will break. Getting my point? So either separate from wife or separate from family, one of the things you have to do. both the things will not happen. So that is a very extensive thing in astrology. Comes from classical astrology. Got my point? So a planet being in Gandhant is something important. A planet being in Gandhant is very essential. And there is a Rashi Gandhant, there is a Tithi Gandhant, there is a Gola Gandhant. So there are 3-4 types of Gandhant also, not getting too complex. Remaining to our topic, right? Because if you say, sir, deal something extensively, then my friend, you don't know the definition of extensive. Your data plan, you will lose. But the extensiveness will not end. So saving your data plan. Coming back to my point. Got it? Okay. That is about Gandhant. Important, crucial. Before I go, for Pushya, let me tell you 2-3 remedies. Pushya means nourishment, and nourishment comes through the cow. Pushya also indicates the udder of the cow. So for Pushya, you should give something to eat to the cow. Right? So jaggery or rice, grass is given to cow is very important for Pushya. Specifically, you know, in the Hindu religion, there is a tradition of giving the first chapati, giving the first roti to the cow. That is a very important thing that Pushya people need to do. Second thing related to Pushya is nourishment. So Pushya people should have a habit of donating money to some religious or non-governmental institutions, giving some money, some goods to those people who are underprivileged to have it, to nourish them, to support them, right? And the third thing about Pushya is the birth of Jupiter. So a very good and very powerful remedy for Pushya people is to write, to give birth to a new thought, and to distribute books, not to children, but to people who need it, who will read it, who will understand it. So if you have a strong Pushya, ask me for the books that I want. Okay? Because I read it. Jokes apart. Don't take it seriously, okay? Coming to Aslesha. Regarding snakes, 3 remedies once again. Do you give milk to snakes on Naga Panchami? Snakes cannot drink milk. Okay. Giving it to them is of no use. Okay. One of the important remedy for Aslesha, that first of all, Aslesha is a Gandhant, right? For every Gandhant, there is extensive method of worship. That every Pandit will know. Better consult a Pandit and get a full-fledged puja done. Remedy one. Remedy two, you know how a Gandhanta Shanti is done. Suppose you are born in Aslesha Gandhanta, okay? Then moon will come in Aslesha after 27 days, after 1 month again. Then after that 1 month, the puja for the propitiation of Aslesha will be done. So you do one particular thing. If you are born in Aslesha, every month when moon comes in Aslesha, you do the mantra of moon. Imam Devasapatana is the Vedic mantra, and there are Dudhi Sangutu Sarabham, one more mantra. There are multiple mantras for moon. So whenever moon comes in Aslesha for that particular month, moon will come in every star every month. When moon comes in Aslesha for that particular month, you do the mantra of moon. For at least 108 times, right? That will be a very good remedy. Another remedy is mix sugar with jaggery and put it on the opening of all the holes in the earth, because holes in the earth are considered a place for the ants to live and other animals to live. So you should put some sugar mixed with jaggery to that hole. Make sure not to block it. Janwara ko marna nahi. Make sure not to block it so the animal should not die who is living inside. Just a bit small of it. And don't give too much. Second thing. And the third thing, there are trees for every nakshatra. And for Gandhan people specifically, you should plant that tree. Want the list of the tree that is in the world? Okay. Don't ask me that. Generally, for you, you can take any tree that you like. Okay. Mango tree or any other tree that you like. As the tree will grow, the nakshatra will be strong. So make sure that the tree grows. If any animal comes and eats the tree, you're bad. Nakshatra is gone. Plant the tree in that particular nakshatra that you want to remedy. Okay. Few things about the nakshatra remedy. One of the most important nakshatra remedies is donating something when that nakshatra comes. Any good thing, right? Donation, giving food, etc. When you do it on a particular nakshatra, you remedy that nakshatra. Okay. So if you want to remedy Ashlesha, all the donations, charity that you want to do, do it in the Ashlesha nakshatra. If you want to remedy Pushya, do it in the Pushya nakshatra. If you want to remedy Bharani, do it in the Bharani nakshatra. Simple. Right. So because of Ashlesha, I have given you a common remedy for every nakshatra, right? Although nakshatra remedies like astrological remedies are also once again very extensive. And there is a separate mantra for Ashlesha as well. That can also be done if you are good in Sanskrit, right? So there are mantras for the nakshatras that can be done. There are mantras for the deities of the nakshatras that can be done. Donation when the moon is in that nakshatra. Charity when the moon is in that nakshatra. Good karma when the moon is in that nakshatra. Worshipping a deity when the moon is in that particular nakshatra is a remedy for all the nakshatras, right? So from next time onwards, if I forget to tell you video for any nakshatra, just come back to Ashlesha video and watch the common remedy. Right? And common remedy, I'm telling it as a common remedy, but it is essential, powerful and good, strong remedy. Okay? Once again, coming to the padas of Ashlesha. Ashlesha first pada. Cancer Rashi and Sagittarius Navamsha. Okay? Ashlesha first pada. Cancer sign, Sagittarius Navamsha, 4th, 9th. Okay? Very good mother and father. But it is Gandhan. And what is the theme that I told you for Gandhan? Either it is bad for the mother or bad for the father, right? So mother and father are very good. They are in love with each other. They support each other. But one of them will start having downfall after the birth of this child. One of them, right? Connection of the 4th house and 9th house. Very devoted to his dharma. 4th house, heart, 9th house, dharma. Very devoted to his dharma. Loves his dharma, wants to know more about his dharma. Someone who is interested in the reading of dharma, Jupiter indicates reading. Right? Jupiter is also exalted in Cancer. So the Jupiter is the Navamsha lord that is exalted in Cancer, the Rashi. Right? Navamsha indicates fortune. So the person is very fortunate, very lucky. Right? Once again, 4,000, 9,000. 4,000 indicates vehicle, property, lands. The person is very lucky in the matters of vehicles, properties and lands. Right? If I have to talk about siblings and children, what I should say, one is male, one is female. So mixed siblings and mixed children, even in that, Jupiter is a Karka for child and Jupiter is a male that is exalted in Cancer. So generally, Ashlesha first pada, three male child, or if mixed, then one female and one male child. For the sibling, because a moon is there, the ruler, I will say, either one female sibling or one female and one male sibling, that's all. Right? How it is for finance? Moon in Jupiter indicates finance and Jupiter is exalted in Cancer, right? So very good for finance. How it is for enmity? Both of them are good planets. So good planet give you enemies but save you from disease. So Ashlesha first pada, many enemies but no disease. Disease free. Right? Jupiter support children, so children they will have. But very good for marital life. Why? Moon will run with the wife of Jupiter. So bad for marital life, bad for relationships. Okay. So you can make n number of results, whatever you want. Or the first pada of Ashlesha. All the results I have told you, like, you know, while explaining it, and have told you a few results also. And let me remind you. I have told a few results and also explained how I made it. So note down the result. And if you're interested in astrology, think on how I made it. Okay. And what is the result?
They are making 6-8 relation to each other.
A 6-8 relation is like that is not something that you should consider in this particular 6-8 relation. Because in Navamsha, all the 12 houses will not be there. There are only 9 Navamshas. So we cannot take 6-8 relationship. We should take Navtara. In Navtara, the 6th Tara is good. And 12 houses are not there. When 12 houses, then 6-8. Right? Yeah, then after 9th house, you will directly jump to the first house because the 10th, 11th, 12th house is not there. So 6-8 relationship doesn't work. Okay. For the sixth Navamsha, the native will have a long and broad physics. Long and broad physique. Jupiter is brihat, big, fat. So long and broad physique. He will have charming eyes. Moon, never stable, right? Moon always looks here and there, right? So charming eyes, right? He will be very courageous. Jupiter is exalted. Of course, you have to be courageous. Along with that, he will also be religious. And he will also be someone who is very much focused on doing good karma. He is someone who will be God-fearing. He will be someone who is very much interested in worship and religion. Once again, Jupiter exalted. Right? He will be fair in complexion. Moon and Jupiter both are fair. Right? He will be good speaker. Jupiter is known as Vachaspati. Good speaker. Vachaspati, the lord of the words. Right? He will possess a beautiful nose. Jupiter is the Karaka of nose. And he will possess big teeth. Moon is the karka for chamakte safed daant. Beautiful white teeth is indicated by moon. So Jupiter is the karka for nose. That comes from Bhrigunandini Nadi. The Jupiter is the karka for nose. But you know, you can look at the nose of a person and you can easily like guess how his Jupiter is. People with good Jupiter, big nose. Bad Jupiter, very fine, small, delicate nose. You find it. You will always have it. Lines over the nose, afflicted Jupiter. Clear nose and afflicted Jupiter. So nose is an indicative of Jupiter. Right? Teeth indicates moon. Cheeks are indicated by Venus. This jaw is indicated by Mars. Eyebrows are indicated by Sun. Different things, right? How to see the face from the planets, let's leave it for now. Second pada of Ashlesha. Second pada of Ashlesha will be what? Cancer Rashi and Capricorn Navamsha, okay? Let's use the hero planet technique, okay? Combination. Let's do it. Moon plus Saturn. Mind, significations of moon influenced by Saturn, signification of Saturn influenced by moon. Okay, let's do it. Moon is the karga for mind, Saturn is sad. The person will be sad. The person will not be easily motivated. The person will have a depressive outlook towards life. Same, I am telling you the same result with four different words. Okay, person will be sad. He will have a depressive outlook. He will lose hope easily. Right, and he will not have patience. His mind will be sad. He will be pessimistic. Same result using five different words. Okay. Once again, moon is the karka for emotions. This person will be emotionally disappointed. He will be detached from his mother and father. You are emotionally detached from your mother and father. He will be detached from his siblings. He will be detached from his wife also. Right. Saturn was cursed by his wife. Right. So husband and wife relationships are not very good. There will be problem between husband and wife relationships, right? Moon is also the karka for money. Saturn indicates delay, right? So the person will start earning money or start accumulating money after much delay in life, at least after the crossing of 35, 40 years of age. I'm considering approximate midlife, right? Person will start earning good money and start saving money after 35, 40 years of age. He will have success in a profession after 35 and 40 years of age. The person will want to do multiple things, but will be taken back by the lack of resources. Moon, fast moving, want to do multiple things, but Saturn, lack of resources, right? Now coming to the signification of Saturn. Saturn is the karga for disease. Moon works fast, right? So the person will be allergic to multiple things. Allergic to multiple things, what do I mean? 6-day cough every month. That's allergic to multiple things. Going further, the person will not be diseased for long. Person will generally have small diseases also. He will frequently consult doctors. Otherwise, how will you have small disease? If you ignore it, you will fall ill for a long time, right? So person will generally consult doctors. He will not remain sick for many long, for much long, right? There will be like, he will be sick for only for a few time, only for some time, only for small time, right? The person will die because of drowning in the water, can die because of tuberculosis, can die because of cough problem. Once again, Saturn death, moon signification. That's a can die because of drowning, tuberculosis, hay fever, or other water related things, right? The mind generally have a sadistic outlook. Achha, how it is for the saving of money? Moon is the karaka for money, and money we have already talked about, right? For siblings, one is Yunuch and one is female. So either one male sibling and one male child, or all female sibling or all female child. Why? Because what I told in Hero Planet, moon either indicates one male child or many female child. So either one male sibling or many female sibling, or one male child or many female child. Right? That is what moon indicates. That is for the second pada of Ashlesha. What is the physique for the second pada of Ashlesha? The native will have scattered hair. Saturn. Right? And moon have open hairs. Right? That is like a female. The person will have a big body. Sandy knees, will be disposed to protect others' families, will be akin to a crow in appearance. Now, you know how I will differentiate between the result of Aquarius and Capricorn? This was the 7th Navamsha, right? And in Navatara, 7 is bad. 8 is not. For the 8th one, I will tell you all the good results. Saturn plus moon is equal to good result. Now I am supposed to tell you good results for Aquarius, for the third pada of Cancer, right? Sorry, for the third pada of Ashlesha. The third pada of Ashlesha Nakshatra. Person is a believer. Person grows slow and steady. There can be delay in things, but that will never be denied. Person will have a good longevity. He will have a very calm and composed approach towards life. Right? Person will be very balanced in his mind, thought, and body. Person will be interested in doing exercise and will be interested in at least having a healthy lifestyle. He will be very patient with every relationship. If they marry late, then the marital life will be good. If they marry early, then the marital life will not be good. If they do love marriage, then it will have a high chance of failure. If they do traditional marriage, Saturn karga for tradition. If they do traditional marriage, it is supposed to last. Right? For finances, it is good. After the middle age, before the middle age, they will earn sufficiently to support their daily expenses, but will not be able to save money. Right? Regarding siblings, they will have a mix of male and female siblings and a mix of male and female children. Generally, they will have very few children only. Right? They will be able to make home, purchase properties and purchase vehicles only after the middle portion of life. And that is for the third pada of Ashlesha. Once again, mix the result. Right? But given it a positive outlook. Because positive result. Okay? Now the native will have a head with bell shape. Right? Like prominent head and broad cheeks. So head long and cheeks broad. So bell shaped face. The person will have a charming face. Once again, Mula Trikona sign of Saturn, right? Person will have a charming face. The person's shoulders and limbs will be of like, like worker. The person's shoulders, etc. will be like someone who is a physical worker. Right, he will have a crooked nose. He will have a bad nose. Right, Jupiter is the significator of nose, and Jupiter is exalted in Cancer, but the affliction of Saturn is coming now. So that's why he will have a crooked nose. He will have a bad nose, disfigured nose, and he will be dark in complexion. Saturn. I told this in Palit Jyotish Prakash, like Navamsha Lagna indicates complexion. Right, so those people can better understand why how it is changing complexion. Right. Fourth pada of Ashlesha, Cancer, Rashi, Pisces, Navamsha. The ninth Tara, the ninth Navamsha, the ninth Tara supposed to be very friendly. But it is Gandhan, the maximum of Gandhan. So I have to keep both of things. Gandhanth is bad for longevity. So things will not last for long, but result will be good. The Jupiter moon, result is good. The Lord Jupiter is exalted in the sign Cancer, right? But it is not long lasting. So person is fortunate, but his fortune will be fluctuating. Sometimes he will gain things through fortune. Sometimes he will lose multiple things through fortune. Should never be in gambling, stock market, etc. Because fortune is going to support him only few times, right? Not always, right? The person is beautiful. The person is intelligent. The person is experienced. The person will have wisdom. The person is learned. Right? There is the combination between the 4th house and the 12th house. It is a very good combination for moksha. The person can really invest in property and vehicle. Right? If he gets anything through inheritance, that will be of no use. But if he makes things using his own hard-earned money, then that thing will be long-lasting. Right? Pisces is the exaltation of Venus and debilitation of Mercury, and Cancer is the exaltation of Jupiter and debilitation of Mars. So let's keep on mixing it, right? Exalted Jupiter, exalted Venus. Very good approach towards luck, very good approach towards love, very good better life. Wife is devoted, husband is devoted. There are very few cases of cheating, right? Now Jupiter Mercury, he is very intelligent, but will not be able to convey his thoughts easily using his words, right? There can be problem in understanding and contemplation, right? The person is generally underachiever. He is not given the right credit that he deserves because one of them is lacking, right? Either the person is highly fickle-minded, Mercury, or the person is, having so much patience that things pass, but he don't take any action, right? That is the mixing of Jupiter and Mercury. In the same way, I can do for Mars and Venus, debilitated Mars and exalted Venus. The person may have multiple flings. Before marriage will happen, he may be into multiple relationships. He may get cheated in multiple relationships. Even after marriage, many people of opposite gender may be attracted to them, disturbing their marital life. Right? Negative Mars, positive Venus. Right? But the person will not pay any heed to those people who are running behind him, but will be devoted to his wife. The first result that we already told, right? Not contradicting the previous result. Right? The person will be good in mathematics. The person will be good in astrology. Right? Why good in astrology and good in mathematics? Read Saravali and a Venus-Mars combination. Open Saravali, read Venus-Mars combination. You will understand why I'm saying good in mathematics, etc. Right? Good in mathematics, good in astrology, and good in appearance, generally healthy. Right? Negative Mars and negative Mercury, there will be fights because of his speech. He will not be able to control his words. He will not be able to convey his thoughts. His words will mainly lead to fight. If he ever gets into a litigation, he is supposed to lose the fight because once again, Mercury is not supporting Mars, right? Even when he is not culprit, he will not be able to give his defense in a very appropriate manner, and that will result in the person losing, right? That is for the fourth pada of oscillation, right? Because I have my moon also in Ashlesha, that's why I have expanded the result very extensively, right? You are really benefiting from my channel when you watch a video, note results down and think over it. Then my channel is really benefiting you. Otherwise, enjoy watching, right?